This tutorial is part of our full-stack React Django DRF channels project, DJ Chat. You can watch this tutorial and many more from our YouTube course playlist, or the whole course, including access to additional resources from our Udemy course. The Udemy course link, which provides the best price for the course, is in the video description. So now we're going to start building the chat server administration app. This app will serve as the server and channel management system app. So it's going to provide all the logic, the API endpoints to retrieve lists of servers and associated channels. This whole section of the course is very much focused in on building a single view set, which is responsible for retrieving a list of servers and associated channels based upon various query parameters. I have created some documentation which does outline the functionality or the specifications of this view set that we're going to be building. Ultimately, we're building a single view set which provides the capabilities of, like I said, parsing various query parameters and acts as a filter in order to collect specific data from the database and then return it so it can then be rendered or used on the front end. We'll talk a little bit more about the specifications as we start building the view set and the functionality within that view set. So we're now going to build a new app for this functionality or for this component of our application. So remember, we're building a component which is dedicated to providing or housing all the logic associated to managing servers. So just before you do this, make sure that you are in the virtual environment. You should be able to then navigate, if you haven't already, into DJ Chat. And then from there, we can now type in manage.py and then run start app. So this is going to build a new app folder in our project, in our DJ Chat directory here. So let's go ahead now and just name this new app that we want to build. So we're just going to call this maybe server or servers, typically not plural, so singular. So start app server. So you may be wondering why we need to create a new folder to do this. Why can't we just use the existing structure? So Django does promote the idea of breaking functionality into apps. And this ultimately creates a clean, maintainable, and scalable code base, which ultimately benefits both developers and end user. One of the main benefits of breaking functionality into apps in Django is modularity. So apps provide a modular structure that separates different parts of the project, making it easy to maintain and manage. As we develop the application, we're always thinking about reusability. So apps can be reused across different projects or instances with the same project, reducing development time and effort. Other benefits include testing and documentation. Apps provide a clear boundary for testing and documentation. It makes it easier to write and maintain documentation for individual parts of the project, and it makes it easier for you to test individual parts of the project, making it easy to identify and fix bugs. Right, so we now have our server app, which is going to host all the logic associated to managing or administrating servers in our application. So we can see now by creating a new app, Django has created a number of different files, which we're describing use as we work through this project. One thing we can do straight away is just remove the test file here. We use a slightly different structure, so we can remove that file. Just make sure that you don't delete any other files in this folder app structure.